Hi, I'm Chris from Dynojet. Today we're going to discuss the adding of Power Commander 5 accessories to the device network. Every Power Commander 5 accessory is going to come with one CAN link cable and one CAN termination plug. The CAN termination plug is very commonly overlooked. It is a necessity that this termination plug be installed at the end of our CAN bus. For instance, if we were to add the AutoTune ignition module, secondary fuel module, or even the LCD to the Power Commander 5, you'll notice that every accessory has two CAN port plugs, much like the Power Commander has. In order to link these together, you'll need to connect the CAN cable to one of the ports on the Power Commander, and it does not matter which port you use, and you'll need to use the other end of the CAN cable to link it to the accessory. Once you have the cable linked in, you'll also need to have a CAN termination plug installed at either end of the CAN bus. So for here, we'll put it in the secondary fuel module. Now, if we were to add, say, the ignition module, we could simply connect a CAN link cable from the ignition module to the unused port on the Power Commander. So now I have a CAN cable linking the Power Commander to the secondary fuel module, and also a CAN cable linking the ignition module to the Power Commander. There's no particular order required. The modules simply need to be daisy chained together, and whichever open port is at the end of either chain needs to be terminated with a CAN termination plug. And this holds true no matter how many accessories you have. These modules do not need to be connected in a particular order. They just need to be linked together through the CAN bus with a termination plug at the end of the chain. I'm going to link an AutoTune kit to this ignition module. And lastly, I'm going to put the CAN termination plug into the AutoTune. And if I even want to go beyond that, I can connect the LCD accessory into the Power Commander 5. So now they're all daisy chained together. Now sometimes you might find that these CAN cables are kind of hard to click in. You must insert them until you feel or hear an actual click. If you're having a hard time getting one to click in, you might find a small plastic burr on the inside of the locking tab. And it can be very helpful to take a sharp knife and just scrape out the inside of that horseshoe-shaped locking tab and just scrape that burr off, and that'll help them lock into the connector a lot easier. Once we've ensured that all of our hardware connections are correct, we also need to add the secondary fuel module and or the ignition module to the network through the software. Now, if you have all of the devices linked properly through the CAN link cable and the CAN termination plug at the end of the chain, you can communicate through one USB cable connected to your computer if you have your vehicle running. If your vehicle is not running, you'll need to have a separate USB cable connected to each individual device simultaneously to communicate with the entire product network. For this set demonstration, these modules are not installed to the vehicle, so we have a Power Commander 5, a secondary fuel module, and an ignition module linked to this computer through three separate USB cables. When we launch the Power Commander 5 software, the software will automatically see that there is a secondary fuel module, and it'll prompt us to add this secondary fuel module to the network. We're just going to hit yes. It'll synchronize. And now it's going to prompt us to add the ignition module to the network. We'll hit yes here. So now all three devices have been linked together as one network. If you do not get the prompts, you can go to Power Commander Tools, Manage Network, search for devices to add. Also, from this same menu, if you ever want to take any of these devices off of the network, you can go to Power Commander Tools, Manage Network, secondary fuel module or ignition module, and select remove. We want to check our firmware by going to View, Device Information. From the Device Information screen, we can see the Power Commander 5 device, and we can see that it's currently running firmware version 01813. We also see the ignition module. It's also running firmware 01813. And third, our secondary fuel module is also running firmware version 01813. If we go to powercommander.com, we'll select the Race Ready side of the website. We'll go to the Download section, and we'll select Power Commander 5 Downloads. On the Power Commander 5 Downloads page, we can see links to the latest software and firmware versions. Here at the very top of the downloads list, we see Power Commander 5 software 1064. This matches the version number of the software we're currently running on this computer, so there'll be no need to reinstall the software with the latest version for this machine. But if you happen to be running a later software version than what is currently posted here on the website, then you will want to download and install the latest version of the Power Commander 5 software on your computer. If we come down here to the firmware section, we'll see that the latest firmware is Power Commander 5 firmware version 0190. This exceeds our current firmware version of 1813, so we're going to want to download this firmware file. When we download this firmware file, it will come in a zipped format, and where we choose to extract the file is irrelevant as long as we know where it's going. The preferred directory that we would save this file to is in your hard drive under the Program Files folder, the subdirectory Power Commander 5, and then the other subdirectory Firmware Updates. This is the default folder that the software will look for the file. But if you want to save this to your desktop, you can certainly do that as long as you know to access it from the desktop later. Now, to update the firmware, we'll need to pull up the Power Commander 5 software, and we'll need to go to Power Commander Tools, and we'll select the Firmware Update option. We can also hit the keyboard sequence Control-U. Once in the Firmware Update window, we can see the three devices that are currently in our network. All three of these devices need to be updated, as they are all three running version 1813. We want to update them to run 019. So we'll select the first device in the list, which is the Power Commander 5 primary module. After selecting that device, we'll click Update, and we'll open the latest version firmware, in this case 0190. And now that the Power Commander 5's firmware has been updated, we'll go down the list and select the next module, in this case the ignition module. And we'll update it with the same firmware file. And lastly, we'll update the secondary fuel module. Now that we've updated all three modules in our network, we can verify that all three modules are currently running the latest firmware by going to View, Device Information, and looking at the firmware version in each module. In this case, we have 019 in the Power Commander, 019 in the Ignition module, and 019 in the secondary fuel module. If updating the firmware for the first time on your particular computer, your computer will be prompted to install USB bootloader drivers. This usually causes the process to time out and fail the first time, and your computer is going to want to ask you if you want to reboot. If you reboot the computer and run the update again after the reboot, the update should go all the way through properly the second time around. Thank you.